Judge Hlophe defending Julius Silo Malema, also aka CIC. Judge Hlophe uthi, you know, you guys media, you have got the tendency and the audacity of diverting things, moving things from what it is to where you want it to be. And he asked this question because journalists are called to the press briefing, your EFF and your MK Party and other progressive forces, including ATM as well and others. They start asking questions that are opposite. And the judge, Uti, I'm very displeased as to your behavior, stood up, that judge, stood up, Hlophe, and defended Malema and said, I am going to defend Julius Malema. And boy, oh boy, telling them that your behavior is disgusting. Well, let me let me add something, you know, a little bit of something. I have a problem, and my problem is, why does it seem like other people get questioned, but other people don't get questioned? Who is questioning EDA for the money they received in Stainoff? Nobody, right? How? So, is the media fair, free, and independent? No. If they are free and fair and independent, then they will question everybody across the spectrum. And I'm telling you, let me tell you a secret. The reason why most channels are talking about the same things, maybe the political what. The reason why even YouTube channels, we have time to thrive, it is because of the unfairness of mainstream media. I'm telling you, if mainstream media was fair to people, this issue of podcasting and it would, like, this thing wouldn't grow the way it is. But because this mainstream media has got a sense of arrogancy, if they think when you are with them persecuting you, they're going to persecute you with or without fact. They are going to run a button. It's a trial by public court of opinion. Yeah, they can trial you, then trial you. That is exactly what the media is busy doing. They're embarrassing themselves, look, in the media conference here, EFF, by asking ridiculous questions. Well, Minaga, guys, in this YouTube channel, I've got the tendency of not asking ridiculous questions, but I've got the tendency of asking fair questions when I say, if you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel. And you know what I'm saying? We'll bring you more. And also, guys, want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed. So, okay, I'm going to give you the video, Hlophe, defending Silo Julius Malema. But I'm also grieved in media, man. These people are so disappointing, eh? They are serious disappointed, the disappointment, and I side with Uloku Judge Hlophe on this one. When they were defending Julius Malema, I side with them. Good, we call a press conference that is supposed to be talking about this, but because when you've got your own agendas, you came to this conference and now you want to ask that is ridiculous. I mean, come on, you can't do that. Be reasonable, man. Be a human being. Respect yourself. Have some sort of respect. But because they can't wait for that, right? They forever in a journey to to persecute others. Take a look at what Judge Sopa said here.
The Progressive Caucus, we did not call it for any other purpose. And I think the media must stop abusing us. If we create a platform for a particular purpose, we are here for that. If you want to interview Comrade Malema on anything, he will decide when and whether or not to accept it. But don't abuse the fact that we've called you for something else, and then you take that opportunity, you turn it around. I'm also offended. I regard that as an abuse. We didn't call you for that. So I would like to protect him. I have every right to protect any comrade who's being abused and is part of the Progressive Caucus. So please, such questions are offensive. I was asked a question to the Progressive Caucus. We did not call it for any other purpose. And I think the media must stop abusing us. If we create a platform for a particular purpose, we are here for that. If you want to interview Comrade Malema on anything, he will decide when and whether or not to accept it. But don't abuse the fact that we've called you for something else, and then you take that opportunity, you turn it around. I'm also offended. I regard that as an abuse. We didn't call you for that. So I would like to protect him. I have every right to protect any comrade who's being abused and is part of the Progressive Caucus. So please, such questions are offensive. I was asked a question.
Okay. Yeah, so like I was saying, Guti, I think for me, immediately in general, South Africa, guys, it is super biased. Right now, Jacob Zuma had to take SAPC to court. Why? Because immediately they are there instead of teaching people what they're supposed to be teaching about SAPC 1. That's why Zuma took them to court. It's because instead of teaching people what they're supposed to be teaching people, they are doing exactly the opposite of what they're supposed to be doing. And that is to promote their propagandas and everything. And MK Party says, Tina ngeke, ngeke over what dead body, we're not going to allow that. About Daily Maverick. Yo, I'm sure that company hates anything that has got to do with Zuma. Anything. Because they write bad about Busiswe Mkhwebane, about Judge Sopa, about Zuma, anybody that is associated with those ones. Either write any horrible thing. Kuze abo News 24. Anti-Zuma, man. Anti-EFF. Anti-Judge Sopa. Anti, you know what I'm saying? That, there's this thing with media, man. I think. I know but young Tswafisa, I want you to sing the song. When I talk about it, I'm part of the tongue. It's no longer a platform that advocate for human rights. It's no longer a platform. You've got journalists that looks like they are on a payroll from other political parties. Just come and prosecute these people. Come and ask questions that are not even supposed to be about that. And this thing of them actually diverting conversations that is about this, taking it to this, it is something that is now common in the media. Like, it's like these people, they are intentionally running propagandas and making sure that they make you believe lies as if it was the truth. Hey, because they are very good at that. We Jehovah, yarr. They are very good at that. They are very good at making people believe things that have never existed as if they are existing. They are very good at magnifying small things and make it look big. As long as it suits the narrative, as long as it protects the right people that they want to protect, the right people that they want to protect, they will do whatever it takes. And they are actually doing whatever it takes to protect the people that they want to protect. Well, Minage, you and I, we know that we're not protected by them anyway. So, yeah. You know what? I mean, end this video right here.